This prisoner is coming in far too quietly. It looks like he's collapsed in the back of the police van.
Cal, I'm the custody sergeant. Cal, Cal.
He's drooling like mad. He's absolutely heavily intoxicated. He might not even be coming in.
They must get Carl into the recovery position, and fast.
That's it.
But the nurse has spotted something.
Pulling your eyes against me, that means that you're actually resisting me, which means that you know that I'm trying to look in your eye.
Hello.
Carl's pulling a fast one.
Raping me, what?
It's just another day in the lockup.
Get off me!
Welcome to Hull, the gritty industrial city on England's northeast coast. A quarter of a million people, all living in perfect harmony. Except that is for the 13,000 arrests that every year make life a bit more interesting for Humberside Police. For many, the custody suite on Priory Road is a second home. Most are in their teens and 20s, nicked for everything from being drunk and out of control to murder. They're usually moved on after 24 hours, but we've been here for a year.
Dingbats.
Pulling a sickie was Carl Cowop's only get-out-of-jail card.
You're not wrong! I saw him be here.
His antics are no surprise to Sergeant Jane Biglin.
Oh, God, I've known Carl Cowop since he's been 9 years old, and he used to be an absolute scallywag. And unfortunately, he's grown into a great big, dangerous scallywag now.
Is me clothes, please? Please?
To be honest, that is what makes you laughing here, because they do all this, and then as soon as they get a little bit of what they want, i.e. going to hospital, they're then saying, well, if the custody sergeant could consider bailing from hospital, that would be great. So they do try and play us, but I think on the whole we have the upper hand of them, don't we?
Oh, they're not wrong!
Have you had any
drugs? I saw him be here.
Are you ready for him to come through?
No, that's fine.
No, if we can just another 10 minutes while I just finish this off.
Custody suites are never quiet.
This is out of the police.
Officers have brought in a suspected drink driver.
What's your name, darling?
Why are you trying to be all right with me? I'm breaking my arm now.
First of all, I need to speak to you.
Why is he bending my arm around so he can't see it behind me?
When he got the vehicle, he was staggering all over the road, so I contacted him. We've got a breath test, which he provided a positive sample.
So why is he twisting my arm then?
He's twisting your arm. Do you want to give me your first name?
Yeah.
I'm not involved. I'm not involved in all this.
It's a sticky moment for Detention Officer Chris Glue, who's having to use all his charms to calm him down.
What I do is I always give people respect who give me respect.
Yeah, because...
Okay. What's your name, mate?
Because you do all your job correctly.
What's
James that? Gilby.
James Gilby.
Yeah.
Right, James.
This is the police. This is at face value. They get you in the car. They give you a couple of knees.
No, look!
Nevertheless, it's a battle of wills. The officers have to carry out a definitive breath test from James before his alcohol levels drop.
Stop chatting shit.
I'm not arguing with any more pathetic. Shut up.
Failure to provide a breath sample could land him a minimum 12-month driving ban.
Now, please, you'll get one more opportunity, otherwise you'll go straight in your cell and you'll be charged with refusing to provide on the breathalyzer machine.
OK? Take your handcuffs off, put me in the cell and get... Fucking hands off me. They're treating me like I'm telling you, you're
He's going given every opportunity to go through the breath test procedure.
Jacko,
I'm going to authorise a strip search due to demeanour, and then you'll remain in there until you are more compliant with us.
And these will get to see a proper dick on them, won't they?
Shut up.
You little pussy. Look at this. Twist my arm up,
they need to know in known certain terms that these are the rules in here and you will adhere to those rules. They don't manipulate us, we tell them what we want.
Alright, lads, chill.
Right, mate, put them back on.
When I do get angry, then I don't take any prisoners at all. I just tell people what I think, how it should be, and they have to conform.
I'm surprised you had 10-3 lads in here, smashing you up.
Chris did a sterling job though. You know, he tried to engage with him to get to him to focus on him, but then he started to escalate again. Yeah, we call Chris Super Glue. His surname is Glue, and basically because he can do everything. He holds everything together. I've only just thought that. How thick am I?
But Jane's smart enough to spot a faker when she sees one.
I was playing dead earlier. What lads are
I? Know, I was playing dead. I know. On a serious note, Carl,
yeah.
No violence in the suite.
There's no violence in the suite, trust me.
You know, the officer's got his taser with him and we wouldn't like to deploy that.
Taser?
Come on.
Come on, then.
It's a big fella hanging out.
Oh,
yeah, he's always a concern because he's so volatile and he is violent, but he's been fine at the moment.
Two-thirds of all juvenile offenders eventually grow out of a life of crime. Carl wasn't one of them.
What's this gentleman being arrested for?
Breach of ASBO and Section 4 public order. Circumstances, the female came home, was met by her ex. Police have arrived. At this point, he's then shouted up and making threats, swearing his head off in the street in front of all the public, and it's also breaches ASBO because of this.
Was any incapacitant spray used at all?
They've been gas, tasered, electrocuted.
Not today.
A lot.
In the past.
I haven't met you for a long time, but I do know of you.
Yeah.
From years ago. All right. And I'm worried that you might have some drugs on you that you might take in the cell.
Yeah, no drugs, lovely.
So I'm going to authorise a strip search.
Yeah, no. All right.
Okay.
You want to pull back pot some from me?
No, it's going to be a male officer that does that.
Oh, that's...
I'm old enough to be your mum.
You stick your name on there for us?
He is a massive handful, so we really have to keep our eye on him. I'd like to say he's a likeable rogue, but that would be lying. He's not a likeable rogue.
A sergeant of 5 years, Jane Biglin has learned to take custody life in her stride.
I've got a good sense of humour and I try not to take the pressures of the job home with me. Because if I did that, I'd never go out the house, I don't think. So he's laid on his back, but the blanket's going up and down, so I know he's breathing or doing something.
The lockup's hardly a home from home, even for the custody staff.
This is one of our cells. As you can see, it's got a lovely ensuite.
Is it quite comfortable here?
Well, shall we have a look? First time I've ever been on one of them. If I had to spend hours in here, I think it'd drive me insane. But again, you know, it's a room and it's better for some people in here than it is out there. This is where the prisoners go to get exercise. We've got cameras, we can see them at all times, and, you know, it's just a place where they can get a bit of air. Oh, it looks like somebody's actually vomited down there in my lovely garden.
It's hotting up in custody. One of the prisoners is starting to kick off. A known prostitute accused of theft, she's not happy.
Having a consultation with her solicitor, and then she just stormed out of the consultation. She's throwing her tea around the cell and her food, so we'll just let her settle down a little bit and see how she goes from there, but I don't think she'll come out tonight.
After a strip search and a cheese butty, Carl's still revelling over his Oscar-winning performance.
I was playing dead. Tried it, but I didn't work. Oh, I can see you blinking. Hey, Eric, are you Eric? And I tried. You know what I mean? I tried like that. But it didn't work.
But the nurses still want to keep a close eye on him.
All right, my job here is to look after you, Carl, all right?
because I've spoken to the custody nurse and she said, you know, he appears intoxicated. I think his suggestion is he's had some heroin. His observations are that if he goes to sleep, we might not be able to rouse him.
So there'll be an officer on cell watch until they're happy Carl's OK.
I'd rather than 3 weeks in Edinburgh jail than a day in here. He just drags in here, just drags.
You're a fat
Yes. But I'm not in a cell.
maybe not.
At least the furious tieflinger has calmed down.
How are you feeling? Yeah? You're not going to throw it, are you?
The lady of the night wants another cuppa, this time to drink.
I'll come and get that rubbish in a minute. It'll be time to... All right. All right.
She'll fit it. I'll pick it up, darling.
That's very nice.
Things like that make you laugh. She had 5 minutes to think about it, and then is apologising now, and she's cleaning up the tea and the food that she's thrown all over, and then just said, I'm sorry about that. So that does... You've got to laugh about things like that.
She did say she's quite happy to be here for days so she can sleep, so...
You see, that is a sad thing, isn't it? She's a lady of the night. She's heavily into Class A drugs. She's got a lifestyle where she's probably subjected to violence every day. So coming here is a period of calm and serenity to a certain degree.
Checking in at the Priory is Scott.
Miss, has my mum rang?
There's nobody rang for you at the moment. They might do.
Not surprised, anyway.
Another regular, he's been arrested for possession of a knife.
Does he? You're going to be interviewed until quite later on. So we'll get you something to eat and a cup of tea and get you in your cell and then just get your head down for a few hours, love, all right?
But what Scott really wants isn't on the menu.
And I ain't even a methadone yet. And I'm allowed to take it out and take it on the street myself.
We can't let you just administer your own drugs in here, can we?
Well, you administer it. Disgusting, that. Cause I ain't even done that wrong.
You're joking.
That's not what the police think. The list of offences is growing by the minute.
He has further property on him, which does not belong to him. The lady's purse with numerous coins, and also what looks like either a knife or some sort of a utility tool. We have a gentleman's wallet in a different name. He's either been on a fishing trip or burgling, or he's got some explaining to do.
They've decided to re-arrest him for a third offence.
You don't have to say anything, but it may have been
of burglary.
Really, you're guilty until proven innocent.
Ridiculous.
A quarter of all thefts in Hull are drug-related. It could be a while before Scott's next fix.
When you're on drugs, and you've got bad drug problems, trying to get money from it here, there and everywhere, that's all your life revolves around, getting drugs. I mean, you lose respect off your friends and your family. You don't realise who you're upsetting. You've got no routine. You lose self-respect. 15, I started on it. And look, where's the life? You know, you're just existing.
The noisy prostitute has some words of wisdom for Scott.
You won't get no methadone in here, darling!
They're just having a domestic at the moment.
Basically, he's coming off heroin. As she said, rattle, he's feeling poorly. She's actually telling him to be grown up and go to sleep and just do your time and be grown up about it, so it's quite funny.
Does your work get sweeter for this sort of thing?
So she's helping with the detention of the prisoners by telling them what to do.
Do we rattle?
Well said.
What type of a man's that?
But the shouting has woken up gobby prisoner James Gilby.
The police are a set of fannies.
Now he's found a different way to gob off.
You grumbling.
As you can see, he's now spitting through his hatch.
Yeah,
at some point, you will run out of fluids from from whatever hollow fist it comes from.
Shut up, you f***ing Roman!
Detainees come in and they start protesting about being in a cell, so they throw feces up at the camera. It makes you feel dirty. You just need to go home and get in the shower and really scrub yourself clean.
It's enough to turn you obsessive compulsive.
I like my desk to be tidy. I'm a bit anal about that, and you'll often see me cleaning everything up. And I don't like the germs either. Right, you hold the chair. You're not going on the chair.
But she's not frightened to roll up her sleeves when the going gets mucky. One prisoner has just been released, but he's left behind a calling card.
One of the detainees has spat or ejaculated on the camera.
You better not be too close to it.
So I'm now removing the whatever it is.
How can you tell what it is?
By the viscousness. That's how it always dries the same, unfortunately. So it could be a number of bodily fluids. I thought a male would be able to tell us expertly.
Check, Mako, is the camera clear?
Yeah, it's clear.
Camera clear?
Is it crystal clear?
It's free.
It's not a very nice job, but I don't expect my staff to do anything that I wouldn't do.
Scott's cold turkey is definitely getting the better of him.
I feel freezing. I feel sick. I'm in here of all places, and I haven't done no wrong.
17 years of addiction can feel like hell after just a couple of hours withdrawal. But complaining to his solicitor won't help.
I mean, we treat them with respect and dignity, and they're fed and they're watered, but at the end of the day, it's obviously not a nice place for them to be when they're dependent on drugs.
There's only one place to turn.
He's just gone in to see the doctor now.
Right, that's good, because obviously he's got his methadone issues that we need to sort
really
out.
Methadone.
Oh, no.
While Scott pleads for mercy, Detective Matt Collier is looking into the burglary allegations.
Some of the property that was recovered from him has been formally identified. Chiefly the watch by his uncle, as have the obviously the vehicle keys that were recovered. Initially in his first interview he said that the keys he thought were his uncle and he's found them. But he also said that the watch was a present from a girlfriend, obviously that's a clear lie if we now know that that's his uncle's.
It looks like Scott's stolen off his family to feed his habit.
It was a binocular case which contained some money as well as possibility that then binoculars and the case were stolen from his mum's, they belonged to someone else. So we're just chasing up as well, so there's hopefully a couple of charges for theft, I hope. And that's pretty much it, that's where we are.
It's not looking good for Scott. Not that he cares right now, he's been refused his methadone.
He can get sued for that.
The doctor's concerned that as a habitual drug user, he may still have drugs in his system.
I didn't know shit about drugs, man. I've been on it since I was 15 and he thinks I can sleep.
He could have taken drugs just prior to him being arrested. We don't know what those drugs are, and he could overdose and he could die. And that is, they are the implications of those sort of addictions.
Unfortunately, the doctor's the one that knows.
I feel like killing myself. I feel freezing. I feel sick. If they say no, I'll make sure that I will be hospitalised.
Threats to kill yourself are not taken lightly in the lockup. In cell F1, an inmate brought in on assault charges has been spotted making a noose out of some clothing. The team are quick to react. But he's not playing ball. They must remove all the clothing that he can use to harm himself.
If I need to kill myself, kill myself naked.
But he's proving far too strong, even for six burly officers. It's a race to strap him down. before someone gets hurt.
Please, stop.
I can't stop.
He came in with a bit of a history that he was suicidal and he has attempted suicide before. I've never had to deal with somebody so strong as that. Within 2 seconds, he is just a Tasmanian devil. And for one split second there were 6 officers in there and myself. I thought, are we really going to be able to restrain this man? So we've had to detain him and strap him up.
Jane can't afford to remove the straps until this prisoner calms down.
Scott.
And she can't afford to take any chances with Scott either.
I'm going to ask you to move into a camera cell for us, all right?
Following his suicidal threats, she's moving him to a camera cell, where he can be closely monitored.
You've got your blanket, Scott. He's not having his jacket because he may use his jacket as a ligature, and because he's stated that he might take his life, that's why we've removed the jacket from him.
The nurse is checking out the strapped-up man in cell F1. At the moment, he's still too volatile to be uncuffed.
Why do you want to assault a cop? Because that's what it does when I come angry on a morning.
It's just about 10, control and manipulation, and we're not playing. He wants to make all these demands to show that he's the boss, and he's not set, he's in control, and unfortunately he's not, it's the police.
That's how you've got to deal with them. You haven't got to let them get the upper hand of you. Once they get the upper hand of you, you've lost it in here. And it's not good. It's not a nice environment to be in at all.
We're in a very argumentative mood at the moment.
Oh, what an argumentative mood.
There's one rule about doing time. The more you fight it, the harder it becomes. It's something that everyone learns in the lockup, even James Gilby, who's finally run out of spit.
Seems fine, he's laid down now. Appears to be going to sleep. Maybe he's just run out of energy, I don't know, but maybe he's just tired from all the hard work he's just been doing.
I'm a bit worried that he is quiet. I'd much rather he was shouting, yeah.
It's when they're quiet that you start getting worried.
It's the perfect opportunity for a break.
I'm having a bit of comfort. It's like a bloody pressure cooker in here.
You need some time out, don't you, really?
Where the printer is in the actual, in the custody complex, I'll go and get some paperwork from there and I'll just sit down there, out of the way, don't I?
Where
sit?
Is that?
And I just sit.
In the cupboard?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do, and I'm like, okay, I'll just let me compose myself. Ah, okay, here we go again. Let's get my energy levels back up and then go back into the suite.
She'll need that energy. There's yet another crisis to handle.
Is the nurse there?
It's Scott, and he's prostrate on the floor in his cell.
Scott, what have you done?
He said he's fallen off this wall here.
Look, this is the nurse. Talk to
him.
Well, you knew you weren't going to be able to sit on there. It's sloping.
We'll check the video anyways.
I'm hoping that he's feigning an injury because he's been kept in custody. He's alleged that he's tried to sit on the toilet wall for some unapparent reason. Not sit on the toilet, but sit on the wall of the toilet. And he's fallen off and he's hit his head and hurt his elbow.
There's no redness, there's no swelling. It's got no neck pain, he's got no back pain. Obviously wasn't knocked out.
This is him going backwards, right, this is it.
There's no fooling the custody staff.
Hilarious! I think that is quite sad that he is so desperately wanting to get out of custody and go to hospital that he's actually resorting to injuring himself.
At least the angry man in cell F1 has calmed down. They've removed the straps, but kept him on cell watch until he's ready for release.
You've got to appreciate, man, you kicked off, which is why it's secured. And because you can go like that any time, which is why the cuffs have to stay on for the time being.
You want to just go up to the counter?
Scott's moment of reckoning has arrived. Detective Collier has concluded his investigations.
Okay, right, Scott, the decision's been made by the Crown Prosecution Service that you're going to get charged with the following three offences. So if you listen to what the officer has to say, he'll read those offences to you.
For two counts of theft and possession of a knife, Scott could be looking at up to 6 months in prison.
Mobile telephone, multiply, portable fridge, bank card and cash.
My comment to that is bollocks, pardon my French.
So your reply is bollocks?
And pardon my French.
Okay.
But will Jane give him bail?
The officers have been to three independent addresses. Unfortunately, those people at those addresses are saying that they don't want you to stay there. So you are now of no fixed abode. So therefore, you'll be kept in custody and be going to Hull Magistrates Court on Monday morning.
Can I speak to my mum?
You can't, because she is a witness to one of the offences for which you've been charged.
Do you want a drink, Pearl?
Without an address to go to, Scott could just disappear if he's released.
I'm getting a broom.
He'll be off to court first thing in the morning. But Jane's getting out of jail early for good behaviour.
By God, I'm ready to go home. Night, night, y'all.
See you now.
For his starring role in Priory Nick and A Breach of Asbo, Carl Cowop was awarded an £85 fine and 100 hours community service. Jane's Tasmanian devil calmed down enough for the cuffs to come off. For battery, he too was fined £85 and given 120 hours community service. Scott pleaded guilty to theft and possession of a knife. He was sent down for 20 weeks. Motormouth James Gilby never calmed down.
You didn't give me the opportunity to provide a sample of machine soap. You just let me.
For failing to provide a breath sample, he was fined £100 and disqualified from driving for 2 years. It's going to be a long walk home.
The police, you've got to be a type of a breed of a young
Next time, there's a headbanger in the lockup, and it's all kicking off for Sergeant Rich West.
Calm it down.
The sergeant gets frisked by a fresh first timer.
Don't be touching me.
I'm not.
Go on.
And the custody team gets a shower.
What we're going to do is you're going to start behaving.
Friday night on BBC Three looks like this. The final in the series of Come Fly With Me next. Then another chance to see the first in a new series of Lunch Monkeys at 9:30, followed by even more laughs for your Friday night. It's all about the football match in Him and Her at 10.